it's time. It's showtime. It's showtime. My next guest, he knows about showtime. He knows about being in prime time. He knows about the big life. He knows about being celebrated. My first guest is the starting safety for the Super Bowl champion, Philadelphia Eagles. He is the owner of Back of House, high-end fashion retail store, and he is, most importantly, a philanthropist. Please welcome to Money Making Conversations, Rodney McLeod.
How you doing?
Hey, was that enough hype for you, Rodney?
That was, man. You did a good job.
All right,
intro.
Rodney, here's the deal, man. You're a superstar, and I got to treat you like that, man. But, you know, people see you with that helmet on, they just think you're out there tackling people. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. But
you got a lot going on in your life, man. I want to talk about it on the show. Really, man, it's just amazing to see your story, because you come from one of the storied, legendary high schools in America called DeMatha in Maryland.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Man, let me just run off. When I say legendary high school, DeMatha Catholic High School, let me tell you some of the famous people from there. Markelle Fultz, if you don't know him, he's the first pick in the NFL, in the NBA draft last year. Victor Oladipo, he was the number two pick in the NBA draft. Legendary Adrian Big Booty Dantley. Boy, he'd back you down, boy. You couldn't get around him. James Brown, that's my boy. Host of the NFL Today. Cameron Wake. He dominated in the CFL. Now he dominated down in Miami Dolphins. David Aldridge. If you don't know David Aldridge, you don't follow NBA. My man, I had to grab this personal. Clifton Powell, actor friend. That's my boy. Danny Ferry and the drum roll, Rodney McLeod. Man, brother, are you on the wall down there in DeMatha yet, Rodney? They got you on that wall.
Man, you know what I'm saying? Right now they got my picture up.
Yes, sir.
You know, up in the weight room. But, you know, I think they're going to give me a little inductee. That's what I'm hoping soon, you know, especially now that I got that Super Bowl champ tag to me. But, man, it's really an honor, man, to, you know, be represented, you know, represent DeMatha. And you just listed off, you know, a lot of amazing guys. And they're all special in some way that have come through DeMatha. So, it's just an honor, man, to hopefully, you know what I'm saying, be up on the wall beside those guys.
That's just a few. If anybody Google DeMatha Catholic High School, is in Maryland, and you will see, I just, you know, this interview about Rodney, I ain't got time to be listening to all the stars that came from this high school. And Rodney, I want to talk about your story, man. First of all, when I was reading your bio, my minor is sociology. My degree is in mathematics, but my minor is sociology. Your degree is sociology. So immediately, you were my man.
Oh, yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So why a degree in sociology? Why a degree in sociology at the University of Virginia?
Man, I mean, honestly, being an athlete at Virginia, it's hard to be able to balance, you know, the school aspect. Going to class every day, the workload, you know, tied in with, you know, what my job is, which is going out, you know, practicing and making sure I'm prepared on Saturday. So, you know, I kind of had three options. I was kind of leaning towards sociology, psychology, anthropology. So I ended up going with sociology just because I was just a lot more interested in that field. And the classes.
It's an amazing degree, man. My degree is in mathematics, but if I had to do it all again, it would be in sociology, because it just taught me so much about people and how people interact.
Exactly.
And also, I learned so much about what I didn't learn in high school, how much they deny you information. It was almost a groundbreaking decision for me to do and go into those classes, and I just soaked them up, man. So when I saw that you... I knew right along, you have a degree in sociology, you have a strong awareness about this country, about social issues, and things that concern everyday people that a lot of people just kind of disregard. That's what sociology brings to the table.
Exactly.
Now, let's talk about you. You're a football player, okay, and you went to the University of Virginia, and you were playing safety and cornerback in college, correct?
Correct.
Okay, so draft is coming up. Draft is coming up. Did you expect to get drafted, because you went into the NFL as a free agent, undrafted free agent?
Yeah, so there was a lot of speculation on whether or not I would be drafted or not. They projected me more, you know, late, mm-hmm. to possibly priority free agents. So going through the whole process, man, it was fun. I enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. You know, I think my goal, you know, as a child, was always to hear my name, you know, get called.
That's right.
you know, I'm saying the day of that draft, and you know, it didn't happen, and so. You know, it was God's plan, but
yes, sir.
I had a lot of calls going on that day.
Mm-hmm.
Teams calling me, letting me know they were interested. They wanted to try and get me at this or that pick. So, you know, a day of the draft.
Hello? Did I lose you?
I mean, that matters.
Okay.
So, a lot of it, you know, I went through that process. I was fortunate enough and blessed enough to go with St. Louis Rams. They gave me the opportunity, and I kind of excelled from day one, man. It took a lot of hard work.
And, well, you know, we know it excelled because in 2016, you signed a 5-year contract for $37 million with the Philadelphia Eagles. So we know it worked out, Rodney. You know, I read. Now, you know I read and do all my research. So you over here, it kind of worked out. I feel blessed.
It takes a lot to be undrafted, man, to come in, not know what your future holds.
Yes, sir.
And like everything that, you know, you do is heightened versus, you know, a guy that does get drafted. So I had to work extra hard, man. I had to, you know, countless hours outside of the time that they gave to me to make sure that every day, you know, I was fully prepared, and I treated every day like an interview. And I was just determined. I didn't want to go back home. You know, God gave me the opportunity to get my foot in the door.
Right.
And
it's about, getting that foot in the door. That's what this whole show is about. Telling people, if you get a shot, don't sleep on it. And you didn't sleep on your opportunity.
Take nothing for advantage. Yeah. You take nothing for you know, nothing for granted, man. And I think me being undrafted and my story just kind of, you know, propelled me and propelled my career for me not to take any play or any moment for granted and appreciating the game and different aspects. I think coming in the way that I did, you know, it's just a perfect story for me.
That's a perfect story. Now, it's an amazing story, Rodney. Don't sleep on this story, man, because of the fact that, you know, you came from an amazing high school. You went to an incredible academic institution at the University of Virginia. You graduated with a sociology degree. Like I said, that's my minor. I know what you graduated in. That's not an easy degree.
Sir.
That's a degree that makes well-rounded individuals. People hire, you get that degree, they hire you at IBM. Those are the people they're hiring nowadays at these technical companies because they have a balanced vision. So I understand who you are from that perspective. And you were determined to win. You were undrafted, you know, and that's a certain degree of embarrassment because everybody you want to get drafted, but that didn't daunt you. You went there, made the St. Louis Rams, and you signed a contract. We're gonna talk about more about with the Rodney McLeod, Super Bowl champion, starting safety for the Philadelphia Eagles when we come back, about his charities and his business. Money making conversation, man. This guy just signed a contract in 2016 for five years, $37 million. That's a money making conversation. This is Rashawn McDonald. You're listening to Money Making Conversation. On the phone, I have the starting safety of the Super Bowl champion Philadelphia Eagles, Rodney McLeod. Rodney, how you doing, my friend?
Hey, what's going on?
Good. I want to ask you, Rodney, when you sign a contract, your story is amazing, and I want to keep repeating it. I'm sure you repeat it a lot in motivational speaking opportunities that you get in front of adults and also especially in front of high school and middle school students, because I know your range of who you talk to is wide when you become a sports athlete of your level. You come into the NFL as a free agent, and then you've signed this 5-year, $37 million contract. So that's a different group of people around you now. What is Team Rodney McLeod, right, that protects you, that makes sure that you're making the right decisions? What is Team Rodney McLeod?
I mean, the team is really, you know, starts with my family.
Yes, sir.
You know, that's where it all started. Those are the ones that paved the way for me to get to where I am today. And I owe a lot of my success, you know, to them for the sacrifices they made for me growing up, getting me involved in sports in the first place, particularly football. But, you know, I was well-rounded, did a lot. But then, you know, the other side of things, my mom always, you know, preached to me, did my parents in general. Education was always important. And, you know, I am athletic. I am talented. But, you know, don't forget what's important. And at the end of the day, you know, knowledge is power, man, and the mind is a powerful source. And so it was always preached to me, regardless of what I'm doing on that field. If the grades aren't in line, then there will be no more of that.
And, absolutely.
And so I think just the way I was raised, man, it kind of prepared me just for life and everything that, you know, that I've gone through.
Cool. That's cool.
You know,
that's
I
amazing.
Had parents that worked, like I said, very hard. So I know what hard work looks like. I know you have to work to get to see those results that you want. And so that's where it starts, man. I got a fiance. She's a part of the team. And then, you know, I surround myself with the help that I need. My agent, Tony Page, my PR guy, Anton Barnes, and financial advisor.
There you go. Man. Gotta have that person.
It's a lot, man. Yeah,
the tax person.
Yes, sir. there's a lot of people, man, that I can label as Team Rodney that have helped me get to where I am and keep me grounded.
Now, let's go into fashion. Okay, now, high-end fashion retail store. Now, Rodney, who told you? Now, Rodney, see, I think I can dress now, Rodney. Who told you know fashion?
I got to see the style. honestly, you know, starting in high school, you know, I kind of just always trendy a little bit, but it wasn't until, you know, I started getting around the league, and you know, as you go out,
I don't know, you know, Rodney, tell me Mr. Fashion aficionado,
you know, yeah, whether it's my friends or going to events and people just complimenting your style and your look. And then, you know, I started to be like, hey, man, like, I mean, I like fashion. I like dressing up. You know, it builds confidence.
Yes,
man.
Sir. Yes, sir.
I have a lot of fun. And I was always a guy that likes to present myself well. Mm-hmm. And so it just became my niche. And, you know, I just wanted to take it to a whole nother level and put my all into it. And now I'm an owner of Bag of House right there. Right where I'm from, it's actually right outside where I'm from, D.C. area, Arlington, Virginia, and Pentagon City Mall. And we've been open since late November, and we've just been growing ever since.
Come on now.
It's a blessing.
Come on now. I saw some pictures. That's a pretty big store. How many square feet is that? How many square feet is that store?
I don't exactly know the exact square footage, but it's really not as big as you think.
Oh, okay, but, okay. The image, the pictures fooling me. The pictures are fooling me.
Yeah, but we make it work, man. Mm-hmm. The store is always full.
Congratulations.
Got a lot of nice middle to high end brands. Mm-hmm. Daniel Patrick, Off White, represent other UK. Mm-hmm. So we have some from UK, Los Angeles area, Canada, man. Some local brands too.
Yes, sir.
So we just wanted to bring something special to DC, man. DC, like, we're known for fashion, but you know, we're kind of a little bit behind, you know, when it comes to the New Yorks and the Los Angeles. But we're trying to just be that store, man, that puts you know, DC back on the map.
So tell me, right, how do you promote it? How do you promote it? Help out my listeners. You're a store owner. I know you. Super Bowl champ, you know, but you opened it before you became the Super Bowl champ. Okay,
correct.
So you had a vision to say, man, I'm just going to take advantage of my look. This is my love. This is my passion, and I'm going to do it. So what were the steps?
Man, it really started with first my mentor. That's where it all started. Kevin James, who's now my business partner.
Mm-hmm.
He was mentoring me the entire time prior to us opening up. And, you know, we sat down one day, man, and we had a vision and we had a conversation over dinner. And, you know, that day forward, you know, we understood what we wanted to accomplish. And this store right here is just a start.
There you go.
You know, what the end goal is going to be. You know, we plan to have a few locally, but then also make this thing be global, man. It starts with being able to trust in someone like that, a guy in my position who's not there on a daily basis. You need someone that understands the industry and the ins and outs, that can manage the store day in and day out. And I'm lucky enough to have a guy like that who has a lot of experience and that I trust. First of all,
you didn't open a nightclub, so you know.
No.
So you know some, you know that happens all the time. Opening a nightclub, dude. I can party. I like to party. People show up for my parties. I'm open a nightclub. You know I was so happy when I read that on your bio. But let's switch gears. We just finished talking. It's called Back of House. It's a high end fashion retail store. Go to www.bohusa. That's Back of House, bohusa.com. That's www.bohusa.com. Millennials, come to force now. HBU is a bunch of HBCU campuses around that area up in Arlington. Go up there, Howard University.
Right there.
Come on, throw some love to my man Rodney McLeod. At Back of House. Let's talk about your charity, man, because you're out there, man. You're helping out the community. You're a spokesperson for the American Association for Cancer Research. Tell us about that.
Yeah, man. I recently partnered with them once I came to Philadelphia. So it was a big year for me. I came over here, you know, for football, but then I also met, you know, with this tremendous organization, American Association for Cancer Research, that does, you know, phenomenal job, man, and trying to find a cure for cancer, and not just one. You know, there's over 100 types of cancers, and so many people are affected by it. You know, there's a large community of us. And so I got with them personally myself because of my grandmother that passed away of pancreatic cancer my senior year of high school. And, you know, her ultimate goal for me was, you know, to graduate high school, to go on to college, and then, you know, to fulfill my dreams, which,
you know,
is what I'm doing right now. And so she's always had a special place in my heart. I always do a tribute to her before the games. And when I got to this level, I said, you know, what can I do, you know, or what would she want me to do now that I have this access and, you know, I have this money, but what can I do that's positive? To, you know, better or help someone else that was in her situation or a situation like mine. And me being an ambassador for American Association for Cancer Research is, you know, is my calling. Being able to, you know, help them out in any other way, drawing awareness, putting on events to try and raise money for research, because it costs. It's very expensive, but that's just the role that I play, man, and it's growing, and, you know,
Let's jump real quick to your youth football camp, because I know we are running short on time here, but I want to make sure people understand how you give back to the community before we get off there. You have a youth football camp at DeMatha for ages 9 through 14. Tell us about that, and when does it happen?
Yeah, so, this will be the fifth year, actually, of my camp. And you said it's usually range from ages 8 to 9 to the age of 14, being the oldest. And it's usually held at DeMatha. This year, it'll be held at DeMatha again. Hopefully, it doesn't rain.
I know, that's always a problem.
In the past, on the weather. But, man, we always find a way, and God made sure of that. But it'll be June 23rd this year.
June 23rd.
It's just a great day. It's just a great day.
What can they go to register? Like, is it a website?
Yeah, so we don't have the site up yet.
Yes, sir.
But it will be at RodneyMcLeod23.com. Usually on my actual website.
Cool.
We'll usually post a link on my Instagram.
Yes, sir.
A direct link in the bio.
Because it's going to be packed this year, brother. It's going to be packed this year. You know, it's packed every year.
Exactly.
But it's going to be crazy this year.
200. Yeah, we usually maxed out at 200, but I know a lot of people, man, they're trying to get their kids involved. Good.
Hey, Rodney, man, thank you, man. You're an amazing guy. Thank you for calling Money Making Conversation. I hope I was responsible for getting the word out about how powerful a person you are. Good luck.